weirdly, I was cycling past the other day and I was like, this looks right up my street. This kind of, it feels a bit naughty, it feels a bit colourful. I don't actually know anything about it, but I just, I kind of like that kind of vibe. I think it's going to be good.
What do you think the magic of the West End is as a theatre capital?
Wow, that's a big question. It's got such fantastic shows and actors, and I'd love to be playing the West End one day. It's a great, I don't know, it's just alive, it's ancient, it's been here for ages. It's a special place.
You've got a great new film coming out, I think, a freehander with Una. Can you talk a little bit about that one?
Yes, okay. It's still a working title at the moment, but it's with my best mate Una Chaplin, David Verdaguer, and it's my second film with Carlos Marquez Masset. We filmed it on my canal boat, which is awesome, and I got to kind of pull together all the Spanish team from the first film, 10,000 Kilometres, and all my London-like boat of friends, and it was a real beautiful collaboration, and I really hope people like it.
For people who aren't familiar with the first film and haven't seen this one yet, can you give us a quick synopsis, just generally what the film's about?
Okay, so The Last Film, 10,000, is about a couple dealing with long-distance relationships, and it's just me and David, the actor. And in this one, David is my best mate, and me and Una are kind of in love. We're lovers, and she wants a baby, and I'm entirely sold on it. And it's about kind of negotiating what we define as family. You know, why can't it be two women and a man living on the canals, you know?
Why do you think that word family is one that is particularly important to be exploring at this point culturally?
I mean, it's always interesting to see how our theories of what family is are developing, especially now, you know, finally, like, gay and lesbian rights are being brought to the table and they are being allowed to get married, which is just amazing. It should be happening worldwide. I think this film will be important.
I think the success of films like Moonlight at the Oscars and everywhere else is a real sign that, in terms of mainstream consciousness, openness to LGBT-themed stories is changing to an extent.
I really, really hope so. Moonlight was incredible. I'm so happy it won. It deserved every success.
Thrones coming up to the very end. As someone who's been a part of that magical world, who have you got your fingers most crossed for in terms of how that's going to...
Who do you think is going to end up there? I mean, I think, like everyone, I kind of want Jon Snow and Dragon Lady to get it on, you know? I think everyone kind of feels that a little bit. I really miss it. In fact, this rucksack I've got was my goodbye present from Game of Thrones. It was such an amazing thing to be part of, and I can't wait to watch the next season. I binge watch it. I'm one of those people that kind of waits till it's all out and then binge it.
Aside from a rucksack, what's the most precious memory you took away from that experience?
Wow. Meeting Una. She is, you know, now my wife in many ways. I don't know. I mean, I learned to skin rabbits and I got to meet incredible people and I got to know the beautiful forests of Belfast. Yeah, it was epic.
Have you got a message to fans before you leave us to go and enjoy this place?
Hi. I don't know what to say. Maybe come and see this play. Hopefully it's good. And check out my band, Molotov Jukebox, if you're bored and feel like some tropical music.